Welcome to Learn Telecommunication program. In this video, we are going to talk about 4G versus 5G. Some of us might think why 5G is required when already 4G technology is available. There are problems with the 4G network which is addressed by 5G. So one of the problems is discussed here. So the 4G has sometimes difficulty in handling the many devices from same location. This is a case where there is too much of crowded in the case of events like sports or large gatherings. So how does 5G solve this problem is basically it intelligently transmits to each of the devices with high precision. So this enables 5G to handle 1 million devices per square kilometer. And this precision also reduces the noise in the 5G network so that it becomes easier to connect many devices in a 5G network. In general, if you see year on year, the number of devices connected to the network keeps increasing. And even with this pandemic situation, there are many use cases like work from home, online classes for the students. All these use cases where a lot of devices like mobile phones, laptops, everything connects to the network. And 25% there's an increase in the network where number of devices connected to the network increases 25% year on year. So this is one of the key feature needed in 5G. Okay. When compared to 4G, 5G is not just designed for, 5G is designed more than a phone. So when compared to 4G, 4G is meant only for the mobiles. So though 4G was a good technology allowing people to stream the music videos on the go, 5G is designed not just for the phones. It can handle many devices like IoT devices, etc. Here are the few examples listed down. For example, there is a smart watch running with a low battery. How does a 5G? So 5G can provide a connection that consumes a very little energy. And for industrial robot, the same 5G can give a stable and faster connection. In this, we are going to talk about the theoretical differences between the 4G and 5G. Latency is a network delay. In case of 4G, we have 200 milliseconds, and whereas 5G, we have 1 milliseconds. And in comes to data rate, 5G brings in 100 times improvement over a 4G network. And millimeter wave spectrum. So this was a topic that we discussed in a previous slide. So where 4G supports 4000 devices per kilometer square kilometer, whereas 5G supports 1 million devices per square kilometer. And the speed what theoretical speed 4G brings is 100 Mbps, whereas 5G brings in 10,000 Mbps. So in this example, here also we have an example. So downloading an average HD movie in a 4G network and 5G network. So 4G network takes approximately 15 minutes, whereas 5G takes 9 minutes to download the entire movie. Yeah, and one of the key biggest differentiator from 5G to 4G is 5G is a gateway for the internet of things, IoT device. And also the 5G networking brings a revolutionary for data driven industries, smart cities, infrastructures. So the overall benefits of 5G over 4G are higher speeds, lower latency, and the capacity to handle more devices, less interference, and better efficiency use of spectrum. So the operators prefer to move to 5G instead of building their 4G capability. So in this slide, what we are going to talk about is, so what are the radio waves that 5G uses? So 5G uses the lower band, mid band, higher band frequencies. So the lower band is used for the TV broadcasting and even for the mobile communication, all the technologies like one first generation, second generation, and third generation, and it is meant for a good coverage for larger areas. And the 5G mid-band frequency ranges are used for Wi-Fi services and 4G services as well. And whereas the 5G higher band frequency is used for sensors in cars and the satellite communication. So 5G covers different range of frequencies when compared to a 4G network. One of the key features of a 5G network is network slicing. A single network can be used for offering the various service based on the requirement of the users or various use cases. Network operator can allocate a right amount of resources as per the network slice. For example, one network slice can be designed to deliver a low latency and the low data rates, while other network slice can be configured to deliver a high throughput. So this helps a network operators in reducing the expenses, the operational expenses as well as capital expenditures. Hope this video has given a difference between a 4G to 5G. If you do have, please give a thumbs up if you like this video. And if you have any comments or suggestion, leave it in the comment box.